Welcome back. You're watching the China Show. An update here of SpaceX and the colossal Starship here has suffered a leak. It tumbled out of control in space, exploded during this test flight. It's a third straight major setback here for Elon Musk's company. Let's bring in Paul Allen, who's been covering the story for us here. Paul, what exactly happened? And we did also hear from Elon Musk just in the last hour in terms of how he's framed this setback in the broader scheme of things.
Yeah, let's talk about it in two parts, David, because the rocket is in two parts. We'll start with the booster. This was a quite interesting refurbished booster. It had been flown before on Flight 7. The intention was not to catch it with the chopstick arms this time, but to test a number of different landing profiles and then have it splash down in the Gulf. That didn't happen. That exploded on re-ignition for a final landing burn. The second part, the top section of the ship, the Starship, also did not go to plan. There was no deployment of the dummy Starlink satellites. There was no relighting of the engines in space. And then the ship lost attitude control. We did hear from Elon Musk, as you say. He said, look, there were leaks that caused a loss of main tank pressure at the re-entry phase, and that ship was also lost. So not a great day for SpaceX. Test Flight 9, not going to plan.
Paul, I mean, this all comes on the backdrop of him, you know, Musk returning back to his companies after a stint in the White House. What's next then? What can SpaceX do to kind of renew their new focus, or what's going to be the next plan?
Well, not what's next, is they just keep on going. And there's always a temptation to frame these sorts of, setbacks as major disasters. They're not really. This is just how SpaceX rolls. It iterates loudly, publicly. It's not afraid to let things blow up. And that's kind of what we saw today. We have to remember that at the Starbase there in Boca Chica, there is a whole production line just turning out ship after ship, booster after booster. And every time something like this happens, they take learnings from it, they redevelop, they reiterate, they go back to the launch pad and they try again. Elon Musk still got some very aggressive timelines around this. He hopes to have robots on Mars next year, which is the next launch window for Mars. During this launch, however, we were speaking with a former astronaut, Colonel William MacArthur. He's a little bit skeptical of these timelines. He says getting to Mars still potentially decades away. He says SpaceX might even need to design a new propulsion system that doesn't yet exist. But this objective of getting back to the moon seems to be a little bit more realistic. And this is certainly not the end for SpaceX. They'll be back on the launch pad for Flight 10 before we know it.